It is one of the Indian state with its own greatness, prestige and heritage. This land has an idyllic situation with relief features, flora and fauna, minerals, river systems and different types of soils and human resources. It is a prosperous land with literature, with its own literature, art and culture, and religious, spiritual and historical famous pilgrim centers. Many places in our state are famous for their world heritage and its natural beauty and abundance of wildlife. So these all things make a Karnataka a beautiful state. And this is an introduction of our state. Once again, I'm going to tell your children that is, in this lesson, we will study about our Karnataka. It is one of the Indian state with its own greatness, which has its own greatness, prestige and heritage. This land is an ideal situation with with diverse relief features, flora and fauna, different types of soils and river system, minerals and the human resources, means lots of knowledge is there in our state. And it is a land, it is a prosperous land with its own literature, art and culture and religious, spiritual, historical, famous pilgrim centers and many places in our state famous for their world heritage and the beautiful, its beautiful nature and the abundant wildlife. Now we go to the origin of the name, how the Karnataka has got its name. So the name, the Karnataka name is in use from ancient time, and this land is called as a Karunadu, means what? Land of black soil. Karunadu means this land is called as a, which land is called as a Karunadu? Karnataka is called as a Karunadu, which means the land of black soil. And the Karunadu means which is on a elevated plateau. So elevated plateau means what? It is in a high place. And it is also mentioned in Nrupatunga grammatical work of Kaviraja Marga that Karnataka extends from Kaveri River up to Godavari River. So after independence, India was divided into many states. In 1947, the southern districts of states which were till under the rule of Mysore kings were brought together and formed a Mysore state. And later areas which were Kannada speaking people in Bombay, Hyderabad, Madras and Kodagu provinces brought together. Thus on 1st November 1956, the Vishal Mysore state came into being. So from that day onwards, the Rajasava is celebrated every year on 1st November. In 1973, in response of the Kannadigas, the state was renamed as a Karnataka. So this is the introduction and the origin, how the Karnataka name has been originated. So in this lesson, we are seeing the various things So Karnataka is one of the state, one of the Indian state with its own greatness, prestige and the heritage and many abundance things we have seen. Not only in the nature, not only in the wild animals, but also in the literature, art, culture and also in the religious pilgrim centers also there are world heritage. So and our land is known as the Karunadu. Why it is called as the Karunadu? Because of the black soil. It's called as a Karunadu. And Karunadu means which is on a elevated place. That means we are on a high plateau. And it is also mentioned in Nrupatunga grammatical work that our Karnataka extends from river Kaveri up to Godavari river. It is also mentioned in a grammatical work that is an Kaviraja Marga. And after independence, India was divided into many states. In 1947, nine southern states were brought together and form a Mysore state and all. Before that, it was under the rule of the Mysore kings and all. So after the states were divided on the basis of the linguistic means what? Like a Kada speaking people. So the people who are Kada speaking, they were brought together from the Bombay, Madras, Hyderabad, Kodagu, they all brought together. Thus on 1st November 1956, the Vishal Mysore state came into being. And Rathosava is celebrated every year on 1st November. In 1973, what happened? In response of the wishes of Kannadigas, the name our state has been renamed as an Karnataka. So this is introduction of our state Karnataka. So tomorrow again I'm going to continue with the lesson. Hope so this much you all understood, children. Thank you.